depending on the case. It's a case-by-case basis. If they've been training for years and they've competed possibly in Muay Thai and Jiu-Jitsu.
Well, I don't think that you have to compete in those things first.
Okay.
But it certainly does make for a good case that when you're 18, you're definitely ready.
Sure.
So, you know, you can have someone who's 40 and been training 3 months who isn't ready.
Sure.
It's not necessarily because of how old they are. Looks like we have Derek Smith carrying a belt. Undisputed champion in another organization.
Confident move to walk out with a belt. Like that. Be confident.
And fighting out of the B2 digital blue corner, Shirtsev Borman.
Which it says Derek Smith is 0-0. So,
well, maybe, you know, maybe he won his belt doing something else.
Possibly. So he's 19, 5'10". His opponent, Joseph Borman, is 1-0, 26, and 5'7".
Once again, this fight is at 155 pounds. We have Joseph Borman entering the cage now. He'll be fighting out of your B2 digital blue corner. Well, we have Derek Smith fighting out of the red corner.
Derek Smith with the reach advantage, being 3 inches taller. We see how that works out. Both of the fighters agreed to touch gloves.
From Bainesville, Kentucky, Derek the King Smith.
I wonder what he's the king of.
Sorry?
I wonder what he's the king of.
Maybe it's a mental thing. You walk out with a belt, you have the mental edge over your opponent.
Borman.
Crowd here for Joseph Borman. Miss Kara.
I hope you guys like blondes. It's my natural color.
If you want to follow her on Instagram, you can find her at Kara Scott 14, CarraScott14, 14. Derek Smith kicking off the action, literally.
What do you think that was? Got him in the groin again?
It looks like it.
A couple groin shots early.
It is. I don't know if you remember some of the first UFCs, but do you remember when groin shots weren't illegal?
I do, yes.
And that never seemed to stop fights the way it does now.
Yeah, that is interesting. I've never experienced a groin shot, so I cannot truly.
Ever?
No, I have, but not like this.
Okay.
Okay, I have. But not like this with a cup on, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I guess my point was I have not had a cup on and experienced a groin shot. I guess I did in football, but I don't think it's the same as a big kick as this right here. And he seems fine right now. He recovered. He was resilient.
Derek Smith heavy with those kicks.
Borman looking to take it to the ground, and he does. Right into Derek Smith's guard. But Borman is going for the ground and pound, getting some strikes in. Very active Borman. How much damage do you think those shots are doing, Gina?
I don't think that it's fight-stopping devastating, but it could cause Derek Smith to move a little bit, and maybe Borman can take advantage of an opening.
Smith's corner is instructing him to go for the triangle. Looks like he's got an arm bar.
I don't think so. Wrong arm. Borman escaping to side control. Looks like he's applying some shoulder pressure to hold him down. We'll see if he pops that knee up to try to pass over.
Thus far, Borman displaying more of a ground game, I'd say, than Smith.
Wrap his leg up, Derek.
See Smith trying to get to his knees. Looks like he's going to do
it. He did it.
But Foreman's eager to get it back to the ground. And he does. Nice flare double.
Making it very clear that's where Borman prefers things to be, is on the ground. Borman seemingly comfortable in Derek Smith's half guard.
Well, Borman is definitely controlling where the fight is, but I think in the process he might be taking a little more damage.
Tell him to watch out for the guillotine.
Takes it back down to the ground again.
This is an interesting round because...
Oh, there he goes. Knee slide passing over. We'll see if he can clear those hands off and do a little ground and pound.
All right, that's the end of round.
Got to say Borman won that round, right?
Definitely. He controlled where the fight went. Was able to get the better positions and end up on top with a very good position.
Fight number three. You still have 5 minutes to get your $3 Miller Lite special. Nikki and Amelia, you guys still here? There you are.
We have Miss Shelley in for round two.
Shelley!
She has my favorite suit on.
Does she?
Yes, she does.
Just a reminder, Hard Rock MMA t-shirts, $12 a piece or 2 for $20. Go see Vanessa and Kristen outside where you were felt up by that wand, a magic beeping wand. My wife's wand at home beeps, and it's low.
So we'll see what these guys come out and do differently. I think if you're in the corner of Borman, you tell him to not do anything differently. So we'll see what kind of a game plan that Derek Smith comes out with this round.
Come on, Bob.
Borman certainly seems to be focusing on dominating the position.
The only time you say damn and not talk about his hot girlfriend.
And then he gets his strikes in once he has position, preferably for him on the ground.
Both fighters touching gloves again. We'll see if Derek leads off with those kicks again. Borman will definitely be looking for that to try to get to the ground. I think in the last round, that's how he first got it to the ground, was with catching one of Derek Smith's kicks. Pace seems to have slowed down a little bit starting off with this round. Borman a little more apprehensive to try to take it to the ground this round. Maybe a little bit tired from last round.
Wow, nice shot, Derek Smith.
A lot of jumping strikes, jumping knees, jumping Superman punches from Derek Smith.
Seems to work a lot in the UFC at times, right?
Sometimes.
Sometimes, if it works. Works when it works.
Nice push kick from Borman. Looks like it might have caught him. Looked like it was in the stomach, but apparently it was in the groin. Neither fighter allowed to take coaching advice during this break.
It's turning into a theme thus far tonight is multiple groin shots. Three fights in, three groin shots.
I think you're right. We're three for three.
Three for three thus far.
Derek Smith come over and confirm to Juan Valley that they hurt.
Borman wants this on the ground. He is hesitant to shoot in and just try to take it straight to the ground. He has
to respect
Derek Smith's striking and kicks.
He's trying to lead in with strikes to clinch, but is getting counterstruck on the way in, and I think it's causing him to back off a little bit.
That's number four.
Maybe they need to put a big red X on there. Don't kick here.
Once again, we're here at Expo 5 in Louisville, Kentucky. Broadcasting for free Hard Rock MMA 88, brought to you by B2 Digital, trading at BTG. BTDG.
Touches the gloves. He's not mad.
Derek Smith versus Joseph Borman, 155-pound bout. Borman out of the B2 Digital blue corner.
See Borman unable to get a hold of Derek Smith on this one.
Is there a term that describes a counter takedown specialist, where you wait for the guy to strike and then you try to take him down? It appears that's what Borman's doing, is he's waiting for the strikes to come in, and then he's going to take him down.
I think Derek Smith may have taken that one, so we're 1-1 if you're scoring the way I do.
It'd be difficult to give that one to Joseph Borman, really.
Yeah, I think Derek Smith was able to control the ring and able to keep Borman from imposing any of his game plan to get it to the ground. More effective strikes, strikes that were able to stop Borman from implementing what he wanted to do. So I definitely would go 1-1 on this one.
Headed into the final round. Could see our first fight of the night go to the judges' scorecards.
So we have Derek Smith looking for his first win in mixed martial arts, it appears. Maybe not. We're not sure where that belt comes from. And then Joseph Borman wanted to go 2-0. I really like the new black canvas Hard Rock has here.
That is new.
All right, folks, this is the third.
Very, very clean look.
Joseph Borman.
So that's for you all.
Oh, thank you.
Got here a little gift. Oh, so cookies.
So we'll see if Borman's able to get it to the ground this time, if Derek Smith is able to keep him away and with more effective striking. So far doing a good job. Oh, that kick. And slip. See if he can recover. The corner of Derek Smith calling for a triangle. Derek Smith's corner calling for him to trap one of the arms pushing on the bicep to get his leg in for a triangle. Looks like he's attempting to push back on that right arm.
Early Smith was going for a very high guard up around the neck. But if I'm Derek's corner, I'm almost telling him, you know, guard doesn't seem to be helping you much as Borman is getting many strikes in.
Borman seems to have good ground wrestling. He's able to shut down that guard and keep Derek Smith's hips locked in place, keep him from spinning and controlling the legs. So if I were in Derek Smith's corner, I would be telling him to try to get up as opposed to work from the guard.
Thus far, we saw Derek Smith win round two in our opinions, and that was because it stayed on the feet. When it's on the ground, it appears to be clearly going in the direction of Borman.
Borman's able to get the mount, and now looking for some ground and pound. He's going to have to clear Smith's arms off. Oh, he got rolled.
Wow.
Let's see what kind of a guard Borman has here. Nice elbows from Derek.
Guard is so much easier when you're just watching jiu-jitsu, right?
Truth.
I've been training a little bit of jiu-jitsu, and it seems I would be just, oh, I'll put him in guard right there. But, oh, yeah, they'll be punching you in the face.
Triangle set up for Borman.
He's going for some jiu-jitsu.
He's able to slip out. Now that Derek Smith is on top, he's able to lend some effective ground and pound.
Wow, this could be a very close round.
Borman spinning for the leg. Looks like he's going to go for a leg lock. Toe hold, but I think he's got it reversed. He's got a heel hook there if he goes
ankle.
For it.
He doesn't quite have his toes under his armpit, does he?
I'm a big fan of ankle locks and leg locks, but sometimes you can get, you know, if they aren't effective, you can be put in a bad position. But it looks like Borman was able to recover and go straight into mount.
The round is coming to an end. Wow, that was a difficult round to judge.
I would definitely give it to Derek Smith on that one.
Okay. Once again, Derek Smith out of the red corner.
Derek Smith did a good job of striking when standing up. He was, you know, he did slip. He wasn't taken down, and then able to reverse the position and land some very good ground, ground game of his own until right at the end Borman reversed it. So who do you give it to?
You've swayed me to Derek Smith. Obviously, round one went to Borman. Round two went to Smith. For the sake of being a contrarian, I'll say Borman got three and that he wins the fight.
There we go. We'll see. Both men look exhausted, but good sports.
Mr. Barry here from the commission is a little slow. He's from the street.
You know, to be something that only lasts a total of 9 minutes.
Exhausting.
Exhausting.
The more and more you hear the direction of MMA going is conditioning is what percentage of your strategy for a fight? I mean.
You know, all things being equal, weight class being, you know, the first one you start with, age, skill being the same. At the end of the day, all else being equal, conditioning will usually win the fight. If you can't breathe, you can't fight.
You saw both these guys after three rounds had to take a break on the ground for a minute. I'm certainly not being critical.
Well, I think one thing people underestimate is that wrestling, taking it down over and over and over again like Borman did in the first round, that is exhausting. You know, he's not just, you know, picking this person up. He's picking up 155 pounds, at least, of resisting body weight and throwing it on the ground over and over and over again, including his own self. So, you know, that can be something that comes into play, the fatigue factor in that first round of, you know, putting Smith on the ground again. Looks like we have Kara going to award the winner tonight. If you want to follow Kara, again, you can find her at KaraScott14 on Instagram.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge one scores the bout 29-28, blue corner.
So somebody agrees with you.
Sure. Judge number two scores the bout 29-28. Red.
Wow.
Somebody agrees with me.
A split decision.
And judge number three scores the bout 30-27 for your winner by split decision, the blue corner, Joseph Borman, the mean Philippine.
Well, I don't agree with the 30-27, but it was a good fight.
Difficult to score that second round for Borman.
Definitely.
Girl, but give it up for both of them, and your winner, Joseph Borman.
Thoughts on Borman going forward?